if you have sore throat, this is from my garden. All for you. You put outside, then the rain will come inside. And when you open it, the rain will go all over you.
This is more beautiful, more appetizing.
Yes.
Yeah, like that. Never cover the cherry tomato because they're beautiful.
Okay, you go call everybody.
Okay. Mmm, yum, 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 yum.
Are you happy, yeah?
Yes! Yes.
Good food?
Yes!
It's your house. Mi casa es su casa. Yeah. Wow, wow, wow. Yeah, he can eat the whole pack.
If you help others, your marriage will be double, triple, or multiply, multiply for generations. Original or religions never advocate violence, yeah? They always have the 5 or 10 precepts. Understand, the first one is, thou shalt not kill.
Love you. Always love you. I could die for you, that kind of love.
Okay, let's go Buddha business, huh? Oh, my God, just eating all day. Only because today festival, okay? Don't expect this every day, huh? You don't come here for this, right?
Yeah.
Man, I never know. Maybe you specially came for Moon Festival. You wait until the last minute, yeah? Come here just on time to eat the cake. Okay. Okay. The Buddha, when he was alive, he has also been blamed for things that is not true. You want to know about that?
Yes.
Because I had some bad names, because I thought I am born, you know, I was born in Vietnam, just a small Vietnamese woman. And Vietnam is not like famous or anything about anything, yeah? All you heard about Vietnam is war and refugees and poverty and all that. Just recently, they rise up already. Yeah, international standard. Even they in World Trade, I say
organization.
World Trade Organization. Yeah. Before even Russia. Yeah, at that time Russia was not admitted. Vietnam already inside. But you don't have any translation. You understood English? You have a car? Huh? Okay, good, good. But when I had no back support, nothing, you know, nothing. I was all alone. I went it all alone. If I was born in India and all that, then they would call me Guru, Mataji, Maharaji, Mataji, Babu, Baba. You know what I mean? Yeah, Sami, Samiji. Yeah, Swami, Marachi, whatever, yeah? But I'm born in Vietnam, so I had nothing to be proud of, you know? Yeah, at that time even just, the war was just recently fresh, and Vietnam was still embargoed, yeah? And now it's better, yeah, the country is much, much better, and the government is open, more open, so people can come in and out of the country. You know, foreigners and Vietnamese alike. It's very good. Bravo for that. Yeah. It's even easier to go out of the country for doing tourism now than during the war. Yeah. So the communist regime in Vietnam is not so bad. Yeah, very open. Yeah. Younger generation, open. War's over. All right, I read you this story. It's called CINCA. the Brahmin girl. According to Buddhism and the believer and the tradition, when you read sutra and all that, you have to put on incense, flower, you know, and bow to the sutra first and thank all the Buddhas and Bodhisattva in 10 directions, all respectfully, before you read it, okay? And then you cover the sutra also with silk or, you know, beautiful cloth, and I just make it more popular, yeah, more easy, simple. I apologize to all the Buddha. I say, if I done something wrong, according to the tradition, my heart is full of respect. It's just that I cannot always do that. So please, all the sin, whatever I've done wrong, is all on me. At least other people, they hear the names of the Buddha, according to the sutta, they will get benefit. Yes. Whoever give false speech, he transgress of one principle, in not telling lie. Yeah, okay. We have five principles, yeah, main principle, like shall not kill or harm anyone else, and not tell lie, and not steal, and not commit illicit sex, and not taking intoxicants, yeah. So telling lies is one of the main principles that we transgress if we tell lie. Okay, should tell the truth only. So this story was given by the Buddha while he was in residence at Chetavana with reference to CINCA Manavika. Stretch your leg, stretch your leg. Oh, I forgot. Stretch it. Oh, God. Ow. Ow. I'm also getting old like you too. Yeah. Oh. My knee is telling me that they exist. How we call it? Đâm bố trên mệt quá. Đâm bố rồi đi rồi mai rồi làm sao? Quen rồi cái không có người đâm bố. Cứ dòng hoài không thấy ai mệt. Okay. This probably is told by Anand also. Most of the story was told by Anand, and he said, "Thus I have heard." But this one translated, he omitted that. He just said, "This instruction was given by the teacher." He didn't even say the Buddha. What a translation. Okay. Of course, Buddha means teacher, master. Yeah, but different, wise, compassionate, powerful, not just any teacher. So he should not translate it as teacher here. He should have said just Buddha then.
Buddha.
Yeah, Buddha or master. Like, for example, Guru Nanak would have been much different from any of other Sikh guru at that time. See what I mean? Yeah. Or Krishna would be a different guru than any other Hindu master at that time or teacher at that time. Yeah, there is a big difference. But the inside is different, the outside don't look different, therefore people cannot tell. Unless you are initiated by that guru, and then you can tell. You can tell because inside experience, yes. Okay, this one is about a girl from a Brahmin family. For the first period after enlightenment, the disciples of the master, I mean the Buddha, multiply, and innumerable gods and men entered on the plane of the noble ones. Okay, spiritual practice. And as the glory of his virtues became widely known, rich gain and high honors were bestowed upon him. But as for the sectarians, loss to them were gain and honor alike, meaning the Buddha has become more and more famous. But the sectarians, you know, the non-Buddhist practitioners outside, lost. They lost their fame, they lost their gain, they lost their trust from their disciples, maybe the public at large. Because they all flocked to the Buddha then, yeah. So even as the fireflies lost their brilliance before the coming of the sun, and they gathered together in the street and cried out, "Is the monk Gotama the only Buddha? We also are Buddhas." They proclaim like that. They feel so frustrated, disappointed, because the Buddha became so much famous and many people follow him and people left him also. Yeah, left them. Mm. They say, "We are also the Buddhas. Does that alone, which is given to him, yield abundant fruit?" They're asking question, yeah? "That which is given to us brings also abundant fruit." Meaning, don't just give offering to the Buddha, give offering to us. You also have merit, just the same. That's what they meant. Okay, jealousy, yeah? Also ignorant. They don't understand what the Buddha truly was, yeah? They don't know his power. They're preaching just from outside, you know, telling people, maybe repeating from the Vedas or from some other scripture. But the Buddha is an inner realization, powerful from inside, can bless people, can save people, can liberate souls, even from hell. Different. These people, these other teachers, they just talk, you know, they just preach, but they don't have enough power to liberate people. They don't have the inner realization to manifest true wisdom. That is a different, but they don't know that. Yeah, so you can't even blame them. You see, they're ignorant. They did not understand the true inner power of the Buddha. They just think, oh, he looks like me. You know, he looked like us. Yeah, he also shave his head and wear a monk robe and go back in like us. So what's the difference? Why make offering and praise to the Buddhas and not to us? It's similar like that. Because they really did not understand. Hmm? They probably did not mean bad. They just did not understand what Buddha, what an enlightened saint really means. Yeah. So, therefore, you, all people, give alms to us. Bestow honor upon us, mingle, praise them, offering to them. Yeah, with such words as these, did they appeal to the multitude? But for all their appeal, they got neither gain nor honor. They go out, make propaganda for themselves, but they get nothing out of that. Accordingly, they met together in secret and considered within themselves, by what means can we cast reproach upon the monk Gotama in public, and so put an end to the gain and honor bestowed upon him? They, you know, they are thinking of some wicked scheme, trying to defame the Buddha, yeah, in secret. Okay, these people, these mundane sectarian teacher, you know, who has no wisdom, no enlightenment, no power. Just one fame and name. Maybe like one of you, one of the people you mentioned before. Yeah. Maybe some of them. Yeah, of course. They're everywhere, in every country, there are such people. Mm? Yeah, it takes some great affinity and sincerity in order to discern who is who, nah? Yeah. Because outside look the same anyway, right? Outside look the same, all human look the same, huh? I look like her and she look like me, and I look like her and look like me, and the hair only. She's a Quebecois, yes, Quebecois, yeah? Yeah, they speak different French. I had some friends in, when I met some of them before in Cayman, they are Quebecois. They say they speak French, but I understood nothing. They did speak French, it's just a different accent. Yeah, you don't understand a thing what they're saying. Yeah, I thought they're speaking Greeks or something. Okay. Mm. Now at that time, there lived in Savatthi a certain wandering nun named CINCA Manavika. Nun, a nun, eh? Mark this. Not a normal girl, huh? A nun. She possessed surpassing beauty and loveliness. Wow. A very celestial nymph was she. From her body proceeded forth rays of light even. Wow. It's not a normal nun. She has some good aura, huh? Some spiritual gain already. Yeah. So, listen. Now, a certain harsh counselor made this proposal to her, to this group of jealous teachers, yeah, sectarian teachers. They say, okay, if we engage the assistance of this woman, we shall be able to cast reproach upon the monk Gotama. Gotama means the Buddha. They don't call him the Buddha or master respectfully. They just jealous. They call him by his world name, you know, Gotama, the Prince Gotama. Yeah. But you see, I thought because I was a Vietnamese woman, born in Vietnam, and a small woman, I don't look anything special, so some people don't like. But the Buddha also, you see, has problem. Jesus also had problem. But Buddha was even a prince. And he forsook all his kingdoms and richness and 500 wives or some more. And his winter palace, summer palace, just to become monks, to get to seek enlightenment. Still, I think he just won fame and gain. See that? Yeah, people are not all very reasonable and not because ignorance. Okay, so now they want to defame him, yeah, for before all of his disciples, in the public even, disciples and followers. So they are trying to get this woman to do just that. Because this woman, though she's a nun and has light even, and she's beautiful. It's beautiful and loveliness. So, okay. So all these sectarian teachers agreed to this proposal. CINCA Manavika went to the monastery of the sectarians, saluted them, and stood waiting. But the sectarians had nothing to say to her. So thereupon she said, "What fault do you find in me?" She was thinking they brought her there to scold her or something. Yeah. This question she repeated 3 times. Then she said, "Noble sirs, I appeal to you for an answer. Noble sirs, what fault do you find in me?" Mean, what's wrong? What wrong do you think about me? Yeah. "Why do you not speak to me?" I wonder why. I think they were too ashamed to say anything. They didn't know what to do. So at the end, they say, "Sister," they explain to her. They say, "Sister, don't you know the monk Gotama? He who goes about doing us harm." And they are also the same sect, no? Same Brahmin. So maybe that's why they say they go around doing us harm, meaning including her. "Depriving us of gain and honor alike." So the woman say, "No, sir, I do not know him. But is there anything I can do to help you in this matter? So they say, the teachers, you know, the sectarian teachers say, "Sister, if you wish us well, summon all your resources, contrive to cast reproach upon the monk Gotama, and so put an end to the gain and honor that people bestow upon him." So CINCA Manavika replied, "Very well, noble sir. I will take all the responsibility, have no anxiety as to the outcome." Meaning, consider it's done. Yeah. What a nun. Yeah. And what a monks they are. the whole group of them. Yeah. So then she departed. Yeah. From that time on, everything okay? Yeah. From that time on, because they call her to come because somebody advised them that this woman if you engage her, you can defame the Buddha. But they also didn't know what to do. So they just call her there, and then she stood there, and they stood there, and they didn't know what to say. So, and finally, she keep asking many times. So they say, okay, do whatever you can to defame the Gautama, the Buddha. So she says she will do it. Woman, clever. Yeah. From that time on, she employed all her skill in the arts of a woman to effect her purpose. When the residents of Savathi were returning from Jetavana, in the deer park, right? Yeah, in Benares, right?
Benares.
I went there too, yeah. There's nothing there anymore. It's just a deer park, but there's no deer either there anymore. Yeah. When the residents of Savathi were returning from Jetavana after listening to the Dhamma from the Buddha, she would put on a cloth of the color, red color, and bearing perfumes and garlands in her hands, would walk in the direction of Jetavana. Okay? The followers and the disciples of the Buddha walking from Jetavana go home. And she, this woman, so-called nun, wearing a red coat, you know, meaning very, very opulent, very eyes-catching clothes and perfume and flower and, you know, decorating, makeup herself, walking opposite direction to Jetavana, understand, to where the Buddha resides. Now you probably understood already what's going on. Okay, right. And then the people, of course, ask them, where are you going at this time of day? You know, people ask her, and she say, what business of yours is it where I'm going? Say, mind your own business. She don't even answer. And then she would reply that, and then she would spend the night near Jetavana at the monastery of the sectarians. And early in the following morning, when throngs of lay disciples were coming out of the city for the purpose of rendering the morning greeting to the Buddha, she would wend her way back and re-enter the city. You know, as if she stayed the whole night in Jetavana Park, but she didn't. She stayed in a temple of the sectarian jealous a teacher, yeah. Okay, so people ask again, where have you spent the night? People ask her. So she say, it's not your business where I spent my night. And then she just left again. So after the lapse of a month and a half, she keep doing like this. Yeah. Whenever they asked her this question, she would reply, I spent the night at Jetavana alone with the monk Gautama in the perfume chamber. Yeah. Perfume chamber is where the place where they built specially for the Buddha alone to stay. Apart from other monks and people. So she says she spent the night with Gautama the Buddha in his perfume room. Room, yeah. So, after a month and a half, then she replied like that. Before, she just say, no, none of your business. But after a while, 5-6 weeks, she say, I spend the night with the Buddha, you know. She didn't say the Buddha, say Gautama, the monk. Yeah. And by her answer, she caused doubts and misgivings to spring up in the minds of those who were still worldlings, meaning the one who are not truly enlightened yet. You are not very highly enlightened and not very diligent in practice in order to perceive inside knowledge, you know, not just by hearing, but knowing intuitively inside, or by vision, or by wisdom, knowing that it's not true or it is true. You see what I mean? So they listen to her. These kind of people, easy sway, yeah, faith is not firm, enlightenment little, ego big, ignorance bigger. So they kind of doubt now. They feel like believing in her something, somewhat. All right. So these people are still worldlings, meaning they're not saintly yet. Even though they were monks, even though they follow the Buddha, but they are not above the world level yet. Not above human level yet. They call them worldlings. So these worldlings had doubt in their mind, so they said to themselves, but who wouldn't, huh? Who wouldn't? This is too obvious, right? The way she was doing is too obvious. Who wouldn't believe, right? It doesn't matter if saint or not saint, maybe the people are thinking like that, huh? Okay. Okay, so they said to themselves, if is this true or is this false? When 3 or 4 months has gone by, she wrapped her belly about with bandages to create the impression that she was pregnant, and dressing herself in a scarlet cloak, she went about saying, I have conceived a child by the monk Gotama. Thus did she deceive utter simpletons, you know, stupid people. When 8 months or 9 months has gone by, she fastened a disc of wood to her belly, drew a cloak over it, and produced swellings all over her body by pounding her hands and feet and back with the jawbones of an ox and pretending to be physically exhausted. So then she went one evening to the Hall of Truth and stood before the Tathagata, mean the Buddha. There, in his gloriously adorned seat of truth, sat the Tathagata teaching the Dhamma. And standing there before him, Cinca Manavika opened her lips and reviled him, saying, Mighty monk, mighty is the thong to which you teach the Dhamma. Sweet is your voice, soft are your lips. Nevertheless, you are the one by whom I have conceived a child, and the time of my delivery is near at hand. But in spite of all this, you make no effort to provide a lying chamber for me, nor do you offer to provide me with ghee or oil and such other things as I need. And failing yourself to attend to your duty, you know, as a father, neither do you say to any one of your supporters, the king of Kosala or Anathapindika or Visakha, your eminent female disciple, do for this young woman what should be done for her. You never said anything like that. You know well enough how to take your pleasure, but you do not know how to look after the child you have begotten. So thus she was reviling the Buddha in the midst of the congregation, in the public, at that time, in the public. Even as a woman with a mass of dung in her hand might seek to defy the face of the moon. Maybe just useless, that's what I mean. How can you defy the face of the moon? Huh? Today is a good story because we have moon festival. I did not think like that, but it's a proper story, huh? Moon story, yeah, okay. So the Tathagata stopped his discourse, and like a lion's roar, he yelled out. Normally the Buddha don't yell, but this, he probably was upset or angry as this lies. So he yelled, like he roared like a lion, saying, Sister, as to whether what you have said is true or false, that is something which only you and I know. He didn't even deny it. Yeah. But this is the thing, Buddha behavior, they behave like that, very noble. He didn't say, no, you tell lie, you woman, you wicked, you do not say things like this about me. You know it's not true, he didn't say that. He said, whatever you said, true or not true, only you and I know. And he mean to her that she know it's not true, and he knows it's not true. But he didn't deny, he didn't kind of like trash her or anything. So noble, eh? In front of the whole assembly of lay disciple monks and nuns and kings and everybody. He said nothing like that. So she said, Yes, mighty monk, but who is to decide between the truth and the falsehood of what is known only to you and to me? She mean, how can we tell anybody else? Eh? Everybody else should know about that. So at that moment, Saka, the gods, the Lord of the 33 gods in the 33 pleasure heaven, his seat suddenly became hot in heaven. It's just a sign of something wrong in the world, some connection with him somehow. So he saw she feel heated, you know, his seat. So therefore he pondered the cause and became aware of the following. You know, Cinca Manavika is falsely accusing the Tathagata. Tathagata is one of the titles of the Buddha, okay? Yeah, meaning thirst come. So he said to himself, the god Saka said to himself, I will clear up this matter. So he set out with four deities for his assistance from heaven. And these four deities, his assistant, turned themselves. Stretch your leg, man. Stretch. Turn straight correctly. Don't worry about the Indian custom with the guru and stretching leg in front of the guru. Nothing. Don't worry about it. I'm not Indian, so you're free. In the Indian custom, you don't stretch your, you don't put your legs toward the guru. You don't sleep with your legs, your foot toward a guru. You don't sit in the same height seat as a guru. Something like that. But I said, I'm not Indian. I'm not a Mataji in India. So you're free. You stretch your legs wherever you want. Okay? Be comfy, you know, because it's not comfortable. Sit long on the floor. I'm sorry, we cannot provide any more than this. Yeah, all right. Okay. And also we age, you know. You and I age, and when we age, the body complain, okay, quietly but very loudly. And here is a little bit like humid in this season, so your bone will feel a little trouble. I put two box of medicine, a small box of medicine outside next to the boiler machine. Yes. When you boil your tea. You use it to rub, okay? Yes. You rub whenever you like and then return it there so other people can use it. There's instruction inside. Okay?
Yes.
Okay, right. So the Saka, the god, you know, Saka, the god, he set forth with his four deities. For assistant deity, you know, the heavenly assistant, his secretaries, and his probably his drivers, and his housekeeper, and another sub-secretary or shadow secretary, what they call it in England, shadow secretary. Sound not very trustworthy, is it? Yeah, in America they say vice secretary, you know. A shadow secretary, and even shadow minister. Oh, I thought this is, what a name, huh? It sounds dubious, you know? It sounds scary. All right, then. So he went down with the four shadows, sub-gods, yeah? And then these four deities, or divas, or whatever, they change themselves by magic. Power into mice, you know, rats, okay. And with one bite of their teeth, they came down, yeah, they came down from heaven, all the way down to where the Buddha sat, and they turned themselves into mice. And then with one bite of their teeth, these little mice severed the cords with which the disc of wood was fastened to the belly of the woman. Yeah. At that moment, the wind blew up the cloth which was wrapped around her, and the disc of wood fell upon her feet, cutting off the toes of both her feet as well. Okay. Thereupon, the multitude cried out, a hag is reviling the Supreme Enlightened One. So they spat on her head, and taking clogs of earth and sticks in their hands, drove her out of Chetavana. Where the Buddha was. The Buddha didn't say anything, but it just happened like that. Yeah. Okay. As she passed out of sight of the Tathagata, the great earth split apart. An abyss opened under her feet and flame shot up from Avicii hell. Thus she was swallowed up, enveloped, as it were, in a scarlet blanket, such as is presented by a wealthy family, and reborn in the Avicii hell. Avicii hell is a hell that is non-stop punishment. You don't have 1 second of rest. They punish you forever and forever and forever. And it could be very, very long time, like eternity. And this is called also like a non-stop, you know, non-interrupted hell. One of the non-interrupted hell, meaning whatever punishment they met it out to you, you have it all day long, 24 hours, every second of the day. They make you die, they make you suffer, and then you revive again, and then you live again, and then you continue again and again and again and again. This is the worst hell of all, without any repose in between. This reserved for the real deep criminal. Understand? The bad, the worst. Yeah. It's not that the Buddha wants it that way. It's just her karma draw her down there. Understand that? Yeah. Not the Buddha. The Buddha never wanted to punish anybody at all. Not even the Sakya God did want that. Just the karma draw people to where they belong. This is terrible to slander the innocent Buddha. Yeah? That's why. Yeah. The slander normal people. Yes, you will also reap punishment, but to slander an enlightened saint, this is the worst you can do to yourself. Yeah. All right, so she went direct immediately with flame, even shoot up to drag her down to Avicii hell. From that time, the gain and honor of the sectarians decrease even further. They want to gain more, but now they get less. Yeah. But the offerings presented to the Master Buddha increase more and more. Of course, now his fame is more than before. Yeah. So actually, she was helping the Buddha. And the sectarian, in a way, helping the Buddha. But as you sow, so shall you reap. They did not intend to help the Buddha that way. They intended to harm him. Therefore, they have to reap the consequences like that. And this is not yet to do with the other teacher yet. It's just the girl only. Yeah. Because she's the one herself thought of this scheme. You see, they also did not tell her what to do. They also didn't know what to do to defame the Buddha. But she herself, though being a nun in Brahmin sect, is also very noble, thought of this way to really slander him, degrade him in front of the multitude. This is a terrible sin, understand? To slander someone and dishonor his reputation is just as bad as killing him, or worse, especially when that person is an enlightened saint and doing nothing harm to no one, just preaching good and remind people to do good or teach them a liberation part, you see? That's why, okay. Now, okay, right. On the following day, the monks began a discussion in the Hall of Truth, just like the Hall of Meditation, where the master always come and teach and preach, you know, where the Buddha come and preach to the multitude. They call it the Hall of Truth, okay? Brethren, they talk among themselves, the monks say to themselves, like brothers, yeah. Brothers, CINCA Manavika, because she falsely accused the possessor of eminent virtues, meaning the Buddha. It's one of his titles also. The foremost recipient of offerings, the supremely exalted, came to utter ruin. meaning this woman, she accused, you know, the Buddha, the Enlightened One, the Tathagata, the Supreme Virtue, etc. They're praising the Buddha with different title, okay? Right. So therefore, she came to utter ruin. The master, you know, the Buddha, approached and asked them, "Monks, what are you sitting here now and talking about?" So when they told him, he said, "Monks, this is not the first time she has falsely accused me and come to utter ruin herself. She did the same thing in a previous state of existence also. Having thus spoken," he said, "unless a king discern clearly fault on the part of another, after himself investigating carefully all the facts, both small and great, he should not inflict punishment," meaning you should not judge before you really thoroughly research about any matter, you know, the fact. Yeah, that's all. So saying, he related in detail this Mahapaduma Jataka story of the past of this woman in connection with him in the former life. Yeah. Are you okay? You want to continue tomorrow?
Yes.
So tired, you all right?
No, we are okay.
Yes. We have some high chair outside. Could you please get me a high chair like that? Then you could sit in the corner. Okay? Yes. Give me a high chair outside. You know, one of those chairs that we put in the kitchen? You know, small one is good enough, just so that he can sit more comfortably. I feel your discomfort. I do feel that. Two chairs. For the two elderly.
No, one only.
One only, okay.
He's 74 years.
Yeah, of course. Everybody's different. Body's different. Age different. A reaction different. So we cannot measure everybody the same. Yes. If he sit in the corner where you sit, then no disturbing. Okay. He changed. Okay, he coming. The chair coming. Okay, so we continue with the story of the past.
Yes.
Yeah. How did this woman, former life, also did the same to the Buddha? Yeah. So she keep going up, slander him and go back to hell. And then after clean up the sin, go back up again and do similar to the Buddha if he came back to life. The same with Devadatta. Hmm? Yeah. Hmm. This is the thing, you know, people are doing good thing in this life or doing bad thing in this life. Yeah, it's okay. Why don't you take the round chair instead? Can you? Yeah, yeah. Anyway, is this chair safe? I saw it broken. Okay, come. Yes. Are you really okay? All right, good. You're a tough guy, huh? Yeah. Corner. Yeah, like that. Be careful with every this spiritual equipment down there. Heavenly ears. Yeah, okay. Careful with the equipment. Okay, good. That's it. Buddha, go up to your days. I'm sorry for your inconvenience. Yes.
Thank you.
Yes, you are very welcome, my love. You're very welcome. Sorry, I should have taken care earlier. But I thought you're a tough guy, you know. We used to have chair and sofa and everything here, but, you know, no room anymore. Yeah, it's not like my house is uncivilized like this. We had dining table, chair, sofa, bed for me and for dogs. Now all gone out. Yeah. In the evening, you can sit on some of the bed, you know, for the boys. And let all the boy go down on the floor and sit there. So a big bed. So you, even if you fall down, it doesn't matter. So it's easier for your legs. Okay? Yeah. There was another person before, a friend. Oh no, Togo. He also has problem. Yeah, it looks similar to you. All right. Okay. So now, so the Buddha relate the. Recount. Raconte. Como dia raconte in English?
Tell.
Huh? Tell. So simple? It's a more elegant word than that. Okay. So the Buddha told the story now of the past life with this woman. Okay. at one time, okay, CINCA Manavika, okay, this is a story of the past title, The Lewd Woman and the Youth. At one time, at that time, it appears CINCA Manavika was reborn as one of the chief consorts of the king, fellow wife of the mother of the future Buddha, a long time ago, yeah. Prince Mahapaduma. At one time, the Buddha was a prince in another country, a long time before he became Buddha. He's also a prince, but in another lifetime, another country. His name is Prince Mahabuddha, Mahaduma. She invited the great beings to lie with her, meaning the prince. At that time, they call her, the great being referred to the future Buddha. At that time, he wasn't a Buddha. The prince saw this woman. She wanted to seduce the prince, her stepson, actually, to have a relationship with her, yeah, physical relationship with her, to lay down with her. And when he refused to do so, she disfigured her own body with her own hand, fake sickness, and told the king, "Your son brought me to this pass because I would not lie with him." She told the opposite story. Understand? Yeah. Woman. The king, hearing this, was filled with rage and straight away flung the great being, I mean the future Buddha and the prince at that time, down the robber's cliff. The deity, dwelling in the mountain, care for him and place him safe and sound with the hood of the king of the dragons. Yeah. The king of the dragons carried him to the abode of the dragons and honored him by conferring upon him half of his kingly power. Wow, so kind, huh? Dragons. People fear them, thinking they're bad. They breathe fire. You know, they're so kind to the prince. Because he's a good boy. You see, when you are good, even animals or dragons or fierce beings, they are kind to you. Okay, right. Kingly power even. Maybe give him half of the kingdom and some of his magical power. Yes. All right. After the great being, meaning that time prince and this future Buddha, after the great being had dwelt there for a year, he conceived a desire to adopt the life of an ascetic. Accordingly, he went to the Himalaya country. Oh, Himalaya country. You know where it is? Just to test. You know where the Himalaya country is? No? India. Only you know? Do you know, two of you? I thought you did not know. I thought the Indian don't know where the Himalaya is, so I just test. Just for fun, I know you know. Yeah, I know where the Himalaya is. I know the Ganga trees, I know everything. I know something that the Indian people don't know. Many Indian people don't go to Ganga trees. You know, the source of the Ganges River? Where the ice melts and become the water of the Ganges, the source of the Ganges River. I went there, bathing it. I told you already. I count 1, 2, 3, jump in and jump out because it's too frozen. Even in May, it's still frozen. The waters just melt directly from the ice and around it's still snowing everywhere, I know. They don't snow, but the snow is still there. It takes a long time to melt because very thick snow in the Himalaya, especially where the Ganges River, the source, the head of the Ganges River, that water is so clean. Ooh. You know, I thought I follow all the Indians who believe that if you bath in the Ganges River once, wash yourself, then your sins are washed. I just make sure that I do it 3 times. Because it's very cold. No, I don't see anybody dip themselves in the Ganges River there. Only I do it. Everybody look. Oh, the Indian, you know, wrap themselves a blanket. Oh, and they just, you know, use some water, dab, 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 like that. And then they left, they believe the sin's gone. I did not believe sin gone so fast. So I did 3 times. And when you come out of the river of water, you feel like your body expands, you know, and like many flowers, you know, open, blooming from your skin. And I did it again and again, 3 times, just to make sure that, you know, everything good is 3, right? They say, so I make sure my sin's gone. I wasn't sure, but just to be safe, yeah. Oh, man. When I came back from that trip, one of the Indian masters, Savan Singh's disciples, he was very old already with the burr, long like as much as the master. And he looked like a master himself. Senior disciples of the older generation. He came and prostrated in front of me. I was so scared. I was reading some discarded piece of newspaper in English. I don't know who dropped it there. I was reading. He came and touched my feet with his head. Oh, I was so scared. I ran away. I wonder if it's because of the Himalaya experience, you know, the Ganges River, that they knew I went there. Mm. They knew I went there. Maybe because of that. Huh?
Is it Charan Singh?
No.
Disciples of?
Disciple of Savan Ashram. So it must be the disciples of Savan Singh, because he's as old, very old. Yeah. That may be a disciple of Kupa Singh, I don't know. But he's very old already. I was only around 30. And his beard so white and long, and his hair white. And he's very dignified, like a master himself. The old disciple, you know, older generation than me. I could call like grandpa, you know. Grandpa disciple or grandpa master, you know, not the same generation. Not the same master at that time. Hmm. So anyway, maybe because of that, huh? Indian people, they respect people who went to Himalaya, Gangotri, and still survive and come back. Because some people don't come back. It's dangerous. They say that. I didn't feel any danger, but they say it's very dangerous to go there. Yeah. If anyone can go there once in their lifetime, then they can boast about it and everybody know about it. And is that true?
Yeah.
But why? Is it dangerous?
No, because it's supposed to be very poisonous river.
It's supposed to be what?
Poisonous river. Gaga is supposed to be very poisonous.
Divine river.
Huh?
Divine river. Pure.
Pure.
Oh. Poisonous. Meaning if you went there and take a bath, then you became purified.
Yeah.
Like a saint.
Right.
Uh-huh. Okay. I should go again and then back again and then more and more pure all the time.
Huh? No, we are coming here for that only.
Not a Gangotri? No. All right then. I'm not a river, okay? In case
no,
you're
not
mistaken.
River. Ocean of love.
Okay. All right. Okay, anyway. All right. So the Buddha say that. His stepmother, you know, the queen, step-queen-mother, a queen stepmother of him. One time, long time ago, when he was a prince, accused him falsely for wanting to sleep with her, and she refused. So she beat herself up, tore her clothes, and to make the king jealous and feel like his son did something bad to his wife. His second wife, no? Something like that. He has many concubines anyway. So what's wrong with the losing only one? No? He has so many wives that some of them he never even know where she lives and what she does in the palace. Most kings like that. They have many, many concubines, yeah? So maybe they have three wives, main wife, and the rest concubine they don't even know. Concubine, he doesn't even know them. Never had a chance to talk to them or touch them or nothing. But nobody is allowed to marry them. Nobody allowed to touch them either. You know, they like finished. Yeah, that's the old time. All right, so now the king throws him down to the cliff, but the celestial beings and the dragons save him and care for him. But in 1 year after, he wants to become a monk. Ascetic monk, you know? Mm. So accordingly, he went to the Himalaya country, you know, right? India. Ah, so everything good happened in India. How come he keep reborn again, again, and again in India? You see, India seems to be the credo of spiritual lineage, spiritual master somehow. I don't know why. Probably is a good place to be because Indian people, they respect so much the saints, you know, and they have freedom of religion. They even worship stone, cows, rats, snakes. Yeah. So they harm no one, you know. So if I go to India, I probably have all the great honor, never slander, nothing. Because even the rat can be guru there, so why not me? I was thinking about that, yeah? In other country, you know, some people believe, some people not. Some people pray, some people slander. But in India, I'll be safe. So one day, if you don't find me anymore here, then you know. You know why. Okay, and you know where I will be, huh? Yes, Indian people, they're so pure. Mm. You know they have temple for rats? Yes. They feed rats. And that temple, one is very famous. Oh, there are many, a lot of rats live there, and they drink together in one bowl of milk. They give them milk every day. And the human came even drink with the rat. Yeah, for blessing, like prasad, just like you want me to give you cakes, candy. The rat, yeah, if they drink together same milk in the bowl with the rat, they feel blessed. Yeah, hear you? Yeah. And then they also wish to be born again as a rat. Yeah, and some people worship, some worship snakes and wish to be born as a snake. You don't know. Indian people, they are very liberal. They respect all beings, yeah? They even worship Ganesh, which is an elephant. Is it Ganesh an elephant or monkey?
Yeah. Yeah, Ganesh, son of Lord Shiva.
Monkey or elephant?
Elephant.
Elephant. Yes. And they also, Hanuman, they also worship a monkey.
Monkey.
Yeah, a Hanuman. You see? Yes. You see that? Huh? Yeah. Huh? Yeah. And here they don't even worship anybody. Not to talk about monkey, elephant, they kill them and eat them. Okay? If the Buddha is born now, maybe they also become soup. Who knows? Yeah. Yeah, if they don't have any more monkey and elephant or rat to kill or to put in a laboratory for torturing test. Maybe they put the Buddha in there. Who knows? Scary human. In India, you see, everyone is safe. I mean, as far as the Hinduism and Buddhism, they are concerned. And afterward, there come other religions, you know, after that, and become less so devoted. Yeah? Mm. Influence from the outside, yeah. Before the Indian people are more pure, yeah. But they still do now in many part of India. When you go to a farmer, I went to some farmer, you know, some time ago on the road and meet some farmer girl. Immediately she greet you, Hari Hari Ram Ram. I mean. Greeting to you, you know, the God, something like that. They treat you like God. And they immediately, on their mouth, come out of their lips, always God. You know, just a rural farmer girl. It's not like a sophisticated master or something. Yeah. It's very, very ingrained, you know, in most of the Indian people. Yeah. Not all of them, of course, but most of them. And still keep this tradition of God devotion, yeah. And all the temple always hear chanting everywhere, you know? Yeah, beautiful. They chant all the time in praise of God, no matter what temple, no matter what they believe. Beautiful instrument they play and they sing. Yeah, beautiful. I'm glad India exists. Yeah, I'm glad. So every year in winter, I repay the kindness of Indian people, yeah, by giving the wandering monks, people blankets and something, what the least I can, yes. Every winter, the monks, they need the blanket, the wandering monks. They are Hindu monks, or Buddhist monks, I don't know, whatever. They're wandering monks, they're really ascetic. They have nothing. Some monks don't have anything to eat for two weeks and something like that, because nobody gave him anything. Nah, never mind. Many humans still don't know what to do, you know, how to repay the monks' kindness, because even if the monks, he is preaching nothing, even he's not like holy monks or not very, maybe who knows that he's holy or not, you see? A monk, he forget all his family already and he went out to become a monk, then at least his heart, you know, is purified and he walk around lending his beautiful energy to the whole country. He don't have to do anything, you see? So they should treat him with respect, all the monks. Okay, regardless of what religion, regardless whether or not you think he is holy or not, it's a symbol of love, of compassion, of wisdom, yeah, of detachment. This is all the quality that we long to have but don't. Okay, all right. Now, so if you offer something to such a renounced person, then maybe he would lend you some of his virtues, you know? And maybe in the future life you can be a monk. You know, detached, at least in this lifetime, feel more detached, less bounded, you know? Yeah. All right, so in India, I heard that you should never upset a monk because you don't know what power he possesses. Yeah, and by upsetting him, that power in him will repose it and return it to you without him wanting it. Understand? He's protected. So just like you spit at the sky and it come back to you. So should never upset a monk. Okay? Never make him angry. Never do anything improper. Never disrespect him. Okay, monk? Any monk? Okay? Like that. And then after that, he go to the Himalaya, adopted the life of an ascetic, and in the course of time developed the direct knowledge by the practice of deep meditation. Enlightened. Okay. Now a certain forester happened to see him there and reported to the king. Thereupon, the king went to him, exchanged friendly greetings with him, learned what had happened, and offered to bestow his kingdom upon the great being. Whoa, I want to give him the whole kingdom, or half at least. The great being, however, declined his offer and admonished him as follows. For my part, I have no desire to rule. But as for you, Majesty, you should keep unimpaired the 10 royal virtues. Avoid evil deeds and rule your kingdom justly. Thereupon the king arose from his seat in tears and went back to the city. The 10 virtues of the royal king is giving, virtuous conduct, renunciation, inside, of course, you cannot go in the forest just like him, but at least inside, yeah. Renunciation, uprightness, gentleness, austerity, non-anger, harmlessness, patience, non-opposition to the will, for the will of the people, not rule against the will of the people, being good and gentle to people. I cannot be king. Non-anger, I fell. You are so scary, Master. Oh, now, Don't make me do that again. All your fault. If I live alone with my dog, would I do that? No. All your fault. It's all your fault. Right, then. Whew. Yeah, so the king cried and went back to his palace. Yeah. On the way there, he asked his ministers, through whose fault was I separated from one endowed with such uprightness like this? Like the monk. So the chief, the minister said to him, your chief consort was to blame for this, your majesty. You know, his wife. Yeah. He's the chief of the concubines. Yeah. Thereupon, the king had her taken by the heels and flung headfirst down robber's cliff. Oh, man. He threw her down the cliff, meaning she would die. Yeah. But when he ordered to throw the prince down, he did not die. The dragon catch him. The fairy care of him. Okay? So now. And entering his city, from then on he ruled his kingdom justly. At that time, Prince Mahapaduma was the great being, and the fellow wife of his mother was Cinca Manavika, the second wife. Yeah. End of the story of the past. When the Buddha had made this matter clear, he said, monks, in the case of those who have abandoned one thing, the speaking of the truth, who have become confirmed in falsehood, who have rid themselves of the chance of a happy next world, there is no evil deed which way they will not commit. So saying, he pronounced the following stanza. The person of false speech, transgressor of one principle, rejecter of the other world, there is no evil he cannot do. Meaning, if you can tell lie, then you can tell can do any other bad deed. Even though it doesn't seem very big, the sin. No, we would think like killing is a greater sin than telling lie. But here the Buddha pronounced that if you can tell false, you mean telling lie, harmless lie sometimes, okay. But like you can, if you accuse somebody or you blame somebody, you know, in such a way like that. You make up story to defame somebody, slander someone like that. This is a big lie. Then there's nothing else bad that you could not do. I mean, if you're such a person who slander and tell lie, fabricate story like that to harm somebody else, then everything else, however bad, other precepts you will also destroy, ruin yourself. Understand now? Yeah. You are so clever. I'm proud of you. Very proud. Yeah, I was thinking there's another story, but I don't know. I will find it tomorrow. Not now anyway. Okay? And then we will have a happy time again, huh? Oh, everybody's happy to be gone now. Keep the chair there. Keep the chair. Anybody else who need a chair like that, we can arrange in the back, okay? And then if you sit on the back, you don't disturb anybody, okay? Yeah. Anyone else need chair? No? Yes? No? No? Yes? Yes? No? Okay, no. All right. Okay. What is you want to show me? Cái gì lạ gì đó hồi nãy nói?
Cái
được rồi, được rồi. Oh, this is Ansham, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, one of my cousins. This is me when I was younger. And my cousin, yeah. My cousin, big cousin is here. He's a soil engineer. And it was me. And some of the others, the niece and the nephew. Yeah. I don't remember them. I just remember him. I never remember that I took picture with him either. First time I saw it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gone, huh?
Yeah. Có rồi. Không, không có cái hình đó nhưng có cái hình này. Okay. This is my parents, my sister, bigger sister, myself, my grandma. And who is this?
Bà nội.
No, bà nội biết rồi. Ai đây?
Cô bố.
Ah, yeah. It's my aunt, the one who owns a jewelry shop. Go jewelry shop. Go and, you know, jewelry stuff. Yeah. My grandma, she lived until 105.
Wow.
Yeah. He's very she's very religious. He was your master. Yeah. Your great master. Big master. Yeah. Big guru. Mm. It's my elder sister, huh? She was not born at that time. A younger sister, a younger brother. Okay, good. Yeah. All right, that's it.
Có gì đây? Ai biết rồi?
Sư phụ gửi lâu rồi, em nhớ em lôi.
Oh, yeah, hả? Okay, yeah. Wow, thank you. Yeah. Oh, wow, thank you very much. Oh. Okay. You want to keep it or for me? For me, thank you, very nice. Very nice of you. You keep so many things. Ah, oh, my God. Can you believe she already has grandchild? Trai, huh?
Yeah,
gái. Gái, so young trai, okay. Girl. my grandchild. My granddaughter. Yeah. She's so young and already have, huh? Yeah, in Vietnam, her granddaughter is also my grandmother. They will also call me grandma. Oh, man. Feeling old. Feeling old.
Yeah,
I did not have this photo with him. I just have this photo alone.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Oh, you want to keep it?
Yeah.
You want to give it to me?
Yeah.
All this? Okay, and this one, huh?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Come on. Come on, em. Mm. Sure. You were not in the picture. Oh.
Not in
the picture. She says special. My sister, she's very sweet. She always say things very nice and positive, you know, loving and kind. She always very, very loving to Sissy, to my mother. I never could be like that. She was always, you know, very hugging and loving and caressing my mother, always, oh, I love her, she's so nice and all that. You know, to my mother. I thought, how come I never did that? Yeah, I never did that. I never did anything like that. Yeah? She always, you know, very, very loving and like clinging to mother and make her feel so good. I said, my God, she did better job than I. You know, she always like coming and carries my mother. Oh, I love her this, I love her that. Oh, mother, you beautiful, you and this and that. I love someone. I never did this kind of thing to mom and dad. My God. Good girl. And she does that to the dog also, her husband also. Everybody loves her. Mm. It would be better if she be a master and I. More sweet, you know, everybody would love her. You know, maybe better. I don't know why God picked me. Sorry, you don't have a better master. You know, sorry for you. You know? She's very sweet. Very, very sweet. Yeah. I haven't seen anybody so sweet like her, like that, with mother, you know? With mother, at least. I don't know how she was sweet with him, but it's with my mother. I wish I could have been like that, you know? When I met her, you know, before, you know, she's always very sweet. She knows how to talk sweetly and positively. Yeah, very sweet person. Lúc nào cũng vậy đó. She's the best in my family. I'm glad we have one at least in the family.
Giờ cháu chết rồi mà còn cứ kêu rể thôi, kêu rể.
Okay. I know. My father, she said my father loves this brother very much. He's actually a brother-in-law. Well, he's just like, he stayed with our family, so I call him brother. Yeah. I don't think he's my brother-in-law. I just think he's a brother, you know? Yeah. And my father loves him very much. Even the last moment before he died, he looked for him. He called for him. He asked for him. Yeah. He loves him very much. Yeah. So it's like a family. Yeah. I'm glad he has such a son, finally. He always wanted a son. He never had. He had only three of us girls. Oh. Okay. Every time mother gave birth, disappointed. How come no boy? Only girl, you know? All right, good. Well, I'm sorry, I as a girl, no? If I'm a boy, maybe better master, I don't know. No? Why not? Men, they deal with stress better. Some hormone, you know, arise. What did you call that?
Testosterone,
yes. The men, when they're stressed or they're angry or they're vexed or they're excited or they're challenged, they produce more of this testosterone, whatever terone that is. And that makes them even more, you know, energetic, powerful, and they live, they thrive on it. On the contrary, we women, we also produce that. If we do similar to men's job, if we stress, and then it's bad for us. It's not compatible to women body to have that kind of hormone arise within us. Understand? Mm. Okay, so if I was a man, you probably have a better master, no? Never scold you. Or maybe like my sister, always love. Love so much. Huh? Nó nói với con cũng vậy đó hả? Hả? Hay là control? Không dám nói hả? Thôi được rồi, chị hiểu. I understand. I ask him if she also sweet like that to him or control him. He don't dare say anything. I say I understood. Don't dare to say, so I understood. It's okay, we keep it. Yeah. Okay, never mind. But you know, if she control you, that's normal. We women, very smart. Yeah. We know what the best. Yeah? Okay. It's good then. They're good together. You know? Okay, any question at all concerning the lecture I just gave you? Suddenly. No problem?
No.
Okay, then that's good. Oh, we have champagne even. Non-alcoholic champagne. Want to drink some? Yeah, you still have your cup? No. Good. I'm trying. Careful. Oh, I'm scared. Somebody do it. I'm scared. Oh, up there, not. Oh, not bay lên nào mà nó tôi sợ. I'm afraid of that. Không biết làm thì làm đi. I don't have enough. I don't have enough strength in my arm. I'm so scared. Okay. You open one more. He open one more. Yeah. And, anyone else who know how? Open one more. Just don't shoot here. Very nice. Just a little bit. Everybody, a little bit each. Okay. For fun. Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. What is oh oh oh? What's that? Oh, more. Then we can have more. Yeah, after, okay? Drink that first, and then we may have second row, okay? Yeah. Right now, I make it more than. Where is yours? Pop. Pop, 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 pop. Welcome, madam. Okay, you do it because I cannot keep reaching. Có ai vậy? Anh chàng kia hả?
Dạ.
Anh chàng kia làm việc mà sao không rượu được?
Uống xịn
nè. Continue, go. Được, go. Everybody one cup, okay? Nice, there you go. Okay, thank you. Here don't have yet? Okay. Don't have? Never mind. You pour out for yourself. All right, it's good? Yep. Yeah, go. Boom. Come here. Your cup. Whose cup is that? Oh, cái này nhá. Cái này nhá. Thêm chút gì vậy?
Xin nhà miếng giấy để tí đạp đi. Cho miếng giấy em.
Giấy xong đưa thêm tại nó bột đâu nghe được.
Đắp nữa không?
Đây. Cheers. Can bay. Oh, quick, drink.
Uống để trà bọt.
Ủa. Thêm. Bài phim là sao? Tôi nói diet. Where's your cup? You have it? Yeah, good. He has it. Some girl take care of him. Don't worry. Good looking guy. Everybody take care. See, nobody take care of me. See, I have to pour wine myself. Yeah, see that? And he already had it. Yeah. Cha-cha. Well, some more here, girl. Yeah, only. I don't want it. Sour, huh? It look like champagne, huh? Look very much like champagne. Beautiful, and it's a bubble and everything. Except no alcohol. Oh, it's good?
Yes.
Happy?
Yes.
Okay, you know what? We're going to eat some of this because always sweet. Huh?
You like cakes?
Oh, I don't like me, but like cakes. Okay, everybody. Okay, huh? Yeah. Đưa bên kia. Everybody won, huh? No. Có chưa?
Yeah.
Oh, have two already. No. One is we don't have a lot of people and time to go by, not because of, you know, Yeah. We can always go shopping. This is better to balance. It was too much sweet before. Have? No have? Anybody don't have? Anybody don't have? Còn nữa. Okay, anybody who did not have? Oh, I have already. My God. Okay, this please bring to the Chinese. Có mấy cái phòng kia nè. Have, huh? One more. Okay. All right. Okay. For the back rooms. Don't look at this here. Don't dream about it. Okay. Maybe tomorrow. Yeah, all right? Yeah. Looks good and well, keep it like that. The Indonesians, very elegant, huh? Yeah. Mm. They even bring this basket and even busted some of this. You know, I mean, how you say? Yeah, so good, huh? How nice, you know, big thing like this, yeah. Big bear, huh? Big antenna. Mm. Beautiful. Basket, look more, you know, beautiful. Biết rồi, họ nói, hồi nãy có nói. Ai dài dài. All the way from Indonesia, they brought these leaves and make it right here. Wow. Can I keep?
Yeah.
Okay. Keep. I don't keep the banana leaf though. But it looks good here. It's beautiful, huh? I keep these good banana leaves, that one, no. And I can put some stuff on it, nah? I don't know what stuff, but it looks beautiful. Quite yeah. Okay. Yeah. I can have the cakes and all this. That looks beautiful, huh? Okay, right. Đây nè. Nó nằm xuống dưới á. Okay, good. Có ba con thôi, đâu bốn đâu. This maybe you don't have in India, try it. You just press it until it's open, eat the white thing inside. And don't eat the nut inside the white. Eat the flesh only. Yeah. Canadian. Brazilian. French Brazilian. Mauritius. Yeah. Australian, yes. Don't have any more of that. Belgium. French, just for fun, huh? Oops, you can take it. If it's run to you, man, it wants you, it likes you. Vietnamese, don't eat. Korean. Mongolian. How many Mongolian? Raise hand. Mongolian. Korean. Yeah. This is a special grapefruit from Asia. It's not the same as grapefruit in... Do you have them green like this? Yeah. Any same? Give to you then. Nah.
Oh, sorry, love. You peel it.
It's still clean if you peel it. No, no. No, 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 no.
Don't be jealous.
No. Right now you eat a lot. No, no, I give him this one. Okay.
Okay, okay,
okay. Lao
Lao. Đó, đúng rồi.
Okay. You Vietnam, Indonesian, they have. Never mind. What is it? Because you don't know it, mostly. So I gave it to you. The Asian people, they know all this. Yeah. Mangosteen. I caught it. Sorry, I can't give everybody. Hey, can open this and everybody else can have? Do you have another one? No, just this one?
I have some.
Mongolian did not have? Have?
Yeah.
Everybody have?
Yeah.
Korean? Singapore?
Thank you.
It's not fair. Singapore have a lot of this. Thank you. Thank you for the coconut sugar. It's very good. I tried. Very nice. Nowadays they make all kind of sugar, you know, more environmentally friendly. Like coconut sugar. Make sugar out of coconut. Very sweet. Yeah. Ai cũng dòm miệng hoài vậy, hả? Dòm quá ai ăn cho được. Ờ, mắng cỡ không chết đưa cho nó cho rồi.
Gọt cái kia tiếp không?
Yeah, yeah, gọt tiếp. Give me a knife or something. So everybody have half, you know, to try. If not, then I eat all by myself. Not for you. You don't have to come here now because... Nằm ngoài cái vườn, cái giường của nó mày đó. You want champagne? No, you don't. I just like to have fun. Oh, why did you bring it now? You should have it before. Okay, you ate up all the storeroom today already, okay? Tomorrow we have nothing. Yeah, understand? Don't think every day like this. It's good. Don't eat the pill just because Master touch it, huh? Who don't have? It's okay. Next one.
Lòng tay.
Olive. Oh, you have already. Okay, then don't need. Oh, sorry. You found it? Oh, good. It's on your body. No problem. Okay, then. Okay.
Don't have also in Mauritius, right?
Yeah.
Rare, right?
This one we have.
You have? This you don't have?
Yeah, this one we have.
India have this, yeah?
Have? Imported?
We have this, but this is
bigger.
Bigger one is lychee.
Yeah, lychee.
Lychee is more famous.
Yes, very famous.
This is called dragon eye. I don't know which part of the dragon eye it is, but they call it dragon eye. It's good. I'm going, guys, because we just sit here eating. I'm not doing any job here. Let me see who I give. Indonesia have this?
Yes.
Then you don't. Here, Canadian. Australian, Brazilian, no, Belgium, Mauritius, one more, please, because you don't have it yet. Sorry, love, sorry, love. Take it, I give it, okay. Some more Indian? Bombay, yeah? Both of you, Bombay?
Yeah.
I have no drink in Bombay. Oh, I don't know how to give you this, so forget it. Oh, it's difficult. You have to cut them, you know? Okay, so... Mongolia. Take it one each, huh? Mongolia also difficult to have this, right? Desert land. Okay, I'm going now, really. I'm going. Okay, huh? Mm. Okay, you cut it small, and then give it to people. Here, you may get out of it. You go kitchen, you make it the mũi đó rồi chia nhỏ ra cho mọi người có hết. Người nào có rồi đừng cho nha. Okay, good luck. I'm going home now. You want to stay? You're welcome. After this, you guys go and meditate, okay?
Yes!
Party's over.
Okay. Yes.